With me is Mr. Zubair Ahmed Malik. He is the chairman of the Federation of Pakistan's Chamber of Commerce, in a sense, a leading voice of private sector in Pakistan. So welcome to Doordarshan News, the national broadcaster of the country. So my first question is, the ITPO has started, the trade fair has started. How many companies from Pakistan are participating in the fair?
This year we have about 87 participants from Pakistan, and we have a complete separate pavilion by Pakistan, and it's number 6 at the IITF.
So most favored nation, it's an issue which has been discussed a lot. The Pakistani government a year back promised that India will be given. What's the view of the private sector of Pakistan over this issue?
I think I gave it very clearly on the dais that India should be accorded this MFN status immediately without any further delay.
So, have you asked your government somehow?
Definitely, we have talked with our government, and I'm sure they will do it. The present government and even the previous government. The elections came, the tenure was over, the things got a bit delayed.
Question to you, so what message will you give to the governments of India and Pakistan over this trade issue?
I think the message is very clear that we have to have peace and prosperity in the South Asian region. And you know, India and Pakistan are two important countries, you know, who can lead or mar the SAARC agenda. So it is very important that India and Pakistan should have a cordial trade relations. And we have also declared in the private sector in Pakistan, FPCCI, FICCI and SAARC chamber, we all believe that trade cannot be held hostage to other, you know, political developments, and where we totally commit that we have to find a peaceful solution, and there has to be a political dialogue. So, but trade should take the lead to bring the peace and prosperity in this region. I think trade is the only hope which can bind and unite the people of both the countries, and which will benefit both the economies.
So, but don't you think that trade gets hits first when there is some problem? It's like two step forward and one step backward. Like 2012 will be the best year probably on Indo-Pakistan trade relations, but 2013 was not so good, I believe.
No, 2013 is still in progress. We had elections in 2013. You are having also elections here. So there are phases in the nations, and both sides, unfortunate, but we have to go by, let the new government come in India as well. But before that, MFN status should not be held because there is a new government coming into India. Yes. Because that cannot be a bargaining chip.
So my other question is, on Pakistan, what's the status of Pakistan's economy currently today?
The economy is not on very good footing. Let me admit it right now. There are a number of factors for it. We are facing energy crisis, and that's another area where India can supplement our efforts in the energy sector.
So my last question to you is, Pakistan has been facing lots of problems, including the scourge of the Taliban, if I say so. How much it has cost Pakistan's economy?
Very heavily. Let me tell you, this war on terror was never our war in the first place. But today it has become our war. This scourge has to be halted. We have to face, otherwise it's going to spill into other countries. And that we don't want.
So can you give me some estimate of how much it has cost to the Pakistani economy?
My knowledge, it's around about $100 billion up till now. And it's a very heavy price for a developing country like mine to pay for it.
Thank you so much. Thank so you. That was Leading Voices from Pakistan talking exclusively to Doordarshan News. With camera person Alu Walia, Sidhant, Sibal, GD News, New Delhi.